IVM.
My favorite link is storytel.com/IVM, which is a lovely place to go. Best books available. I'm not saying that because they're forcing me, but stop choking me. All right, I'll do it anyway. My favorite Harry Potter of all time is Half-Blood Prince. I named my son after Harry Potter. In fact, his name is Blood. J.K. Rowling, amongst the greatest authors the world has ever seen. Nobody knows if she really exists, but as far as I know, J.K. Rowling is the richest woman in the world after Michelle Obama. So keep in mind that if you go through storytel.com/IVM, you get a 30-day free trial as against a 14-day free trial on the link. All right, it's very simple. All you got to do is log on to storytel.com/IVM. Millions and millions and millions of stories, many written by me, all that and more. Find it all on Storytel.
Kripaya dhyan dijiye. The language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative.
You're listening to Cyrus Says.
Forget about Michael Jackson. We have our own MJ here on Cyrus Says, the one and only Manish Jhaveri. What, you haven't heard of him? Are?
Why follow your auntie's advice when you can follow Cyrus Says on Facebook and Twitter to stay updated about the latest shows?
Okay, here on Cyrus Says, I've come up with a concept I want to share, which is to stop all the fighting between relatives, siblings actually, and cousins sometimes. Why can't people draw up their wills well before? I'm going to draw up my will before my kids turn 25, I've decided. And just, that's it. Whatever we earn post that also, it'll just go into the same proportion and the same style. And it's just done. Sealed. Why do everything in the last 2 weeks of your life? And then suddenly everybody fights. Mereko nahi mila, mereko nahi mila. I mean, just, it should be common knowledge. The watchman in the building should know. She's getting 43%, he's getting 42%, and 9% are going to dogs. Oh, that might go up also. Depends on my mood. But anyway, that's my point. Drop your will. Do it now. Don't waste any time. Finish the podcast, then do it. It's called Cyrus Says.
Remember the last vacation you took? What about the one you took 3 years ago? Okay, how much do you really remember? It's a question I've asked myself often, over a decade of traveling the world. Hey, I'm Utsav, and I do not travel the world for a living. I have a full-time job and responsibilities, but I have made traveling the world a priority. Priority enough that I negotiate extra leave in my job contracts, obsessively track my frequent flyer miles, and I'm willing to take off at the sight of a cheap ticket. Yes, I am cheap. I have lived and worked in 3 countries. I understand human behavior for a living. And these experiences have given me unique insights into places, people, and culture. With over a decade of travel behind me, I increasingly realized one thing, that we cannot see everything. So whatever we see, we must see deeply. Because as the film of memory decays, the imprints which will stand the test of time are the ones felt by the immersion of the senses, not by fleeting encounters with them. Postcards from Nowhere is an immersion into the world of slow travel, one story at a time. Tune in every Thursday on the IVM Podcasts app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from.
Hello, Manish Jhaveri, welcome to the show. I say welcome to the show like we've got great sponsors and music in the background. We have neither.
Yeah.
But we live in hope. Yeah. Manish, let me quickly mention who you are. You're a man. Sindhi Gujarati mix, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, you do. Fabulous. Not a bad memory at all.
I think all the creative people are mixed. You know, yeah. I've done a lot of research on this. People who come from different, slightly different backgrounds or mixed backgrounds tend to be more creative for some reason.
Like you're Maybe Mac and
there you
Parsi.
Go. There you go. Yeah, so John Abraham. Yeah. Irun and Malayali, for example.
I didn't know that, okay.
Yeah, and he's a double MBA. Nobody knows that about him because he pretends not to be intelligent. Yeah, but
I think that's his trick, you know.
That's his trick.
That's why he gets all these nice meaty roles. Otherwise, they'd have
now he's giving himself the meaty roles.
that shows he's intelligent.
There you go. See? All right, quickly to tell everyone, you are the award-winning... look at the research my good friend Abbas has done. Just not to give you any complex, but once in a while, they give me some 4 pages. So just introducing the guests is 40 minutes. But now he's given up.
So I have to really do the hard work. We've actually got to talk.
No,
I should have given him a longer intro.
This is not to do with you. This is not to do with you. This is to do with him. He's just come back from Goa. He's laid back and he's done this in a slightly Goan chilled way, which is a teen line coffee. Kuch hoga, bachit, let's tack. Award winning, I'm reading all three lines. Should I go slow because there are only three?
I think you can, reiterate award winning thrice.
Say twice. Very good idea. See how creative you are. Award winning. And we have the reverb facility. Award winning ad man who has been writing the Amul topicals for Dakunya since 1994. That's all the Amul butter hoardings that you see, the catchy hoardings that maybe three generations now have been weaned on.
I was one year. I remember one of your hoardings still, which was Lara Kya Mara.
Lara Kya Mara, which I picked up from downstairs.
You don't have to tell people that.
No, but
it was your hoarding. Let's just leave it at that.
We were eating the fruit. It was 4 rupees at that time. That fruit plate, a mixed fruit plate. I don't know what it is now.
Now I think it's 20 rupees. But
20
then
rupees?
Then it's 5,000 rupees in your gastro and all. It's like,
what are you
it's
saying?
Pretty expensive.
I should have become a fruit wala.
I think the 500 rupee bananas were cheaper.
No, but copywriters are struggling and fruit wala's are, look at this. This is ridiculous. Look at the cost of company.
Copywriters ko ek fruity kodi nahi milti.
Tere ko milta 20 rupees per line?
Such bata.
So anyway, so 4 bucks. So I was standing, he had just made 375 broken Sobel's record, standing outside eating, and these two guys were talking. And just in colloquial terms, and one guy said, "Are Lara kya mara?" It just sounded perfect. That's the genius. I came up and I told Kunal and I don't remember who else was, Deepak Shah. Lara kya mara, what a line. That's the line. Everybody loved the line. It's just very catchy. And Manish, I see many, because I follow a lot of cricket, many writers up till the time he retired use the term Lara kya mara when he made a century or double century or something.
I've seen it at least 3 to 4 times in newspapers myself.
There you go. And there's a guy who should be paid who's not been paid. Some guy in Nariman Point eating fruit next to me. Let's call him Bunty. Bunty is gone. Bunty is gone from 1994.
No, he was eating fruit or he was having Bunty?
Maybe he's having Bunty now because life has gone even worse. Yeah. But he could have been that genius copywriter. You know, he could have climbed the ladder and he'd be, I don't know, who's the biggest gun? Piyush Pandey today. But no.
No, but I've got a similar story.
Please say.
There was when Goran, you remember,
finally won the Wimbledon. 2002, and, or one,
whenever,
or three.
1999, I think.
Okay, nine.
I'm not sure. But sometime then.
Google it, you bastards.
Who cares? So he won after like umpteen attempts. And Rahul Dakuna called me and said, "We have to do a line on Goran." I said, "Yeah, I have."
Babu.
Rahul Dakuna is the guy who runs Dakunias.
And he says Babu a lot.
Does he? Not
Babu.
To me.
Babu.
Acha. Anyway. So, and it was his. It's quite a mouthful, you know.
Right.
I couldn't
get
my...
Huge. Evini Sevik.
Yeah, it was like... So, I'd gone down and I'd graduated from Fruit Wala's and I could afford a sandwich and stuff like that. And I heard one kid hollering to his mother, I want a sandwich. And I said, okay, that's a line. I want a sandwich. Quran, I want a sandwich. And that became like a real big hit.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
So, a very similar Lara Kya Mara story. And that's what happened. You know, if you're a copywriter, it's...
It stays.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, it's people think that all your creativity will just flow from your head. Sometimes it flows from around
ears,
the head as also.
You have to keep your ears open and your mind open.
2 days in the Lok Sabha and we'd have picked up so much. 2 days. I asked everyone, go and do two-day tour. Okay, let's get back to you. Award-winning ad man who's been writing Amul butter hoardings. Also, a scriptwriter who has written hundreds of events, including IFA awards. But this is all later on. Let's start in the beginning. Firstly, I have a little bit of a problem. I want to just get it out in the open. You used to live at Shamnevas. You grew up in Shamnevas, which is in Beach Candy. In 1994, the year you joined advertising, I think, I got beaten up by your watchman.
Oh.
Three of them. This young man called Baman Irani was the photographer. He was not yet a superstar.
I was actually staying just next to him.
So we were doing some play or the other, and he would do the free photography for the play car release and all that. And I drove my little Maruti 1329, which I thought was the fastest car in the west. And
I think
parked it near the dustbin on a Sunday at 7:30 in the morning, because we had to get there under 8 for makeup and all that shit. So I parked it right into a dustbin thing, and thinking they won't bother me, it's my small car. They took out all 4 tires. When we came out at about 2:33, all 4 tires had gone. So when I asked the first watchman his usual, reluctance to talk, and all that started. And before I knew it, a fight broke out. Then the second and third came. And from upstairs, all the Shamnevas society filled with young Sindhi women in the ages group of 30 to 40 were screaming, "Maro, maro, usko maro," telling the watchman to hit me more. Were you one of them?
The watchman? No, I wasn't. I told you I was eating fruit, but it wasn't that bad.
But they beat me up.
No, but Shamnevas...
very aggressive society.
Very aggressive society.
Why?
Very aggressive. I think it's because of the Sindhis.
Stop it.
See, I speak.
True story, yeah, Manish.
No.
And I'm Kunal, not. I'm not surprised. And listen to my friend Kunal and Baman. Baman, 6'2", was hiding inside, saying he loses. He can't get into any fight because they'll take away his place.
No, because Baman had the best of both worlds. Correct. He was staying. I mean, he had an office, a huge office in Bleach Candy, because it was some Russian consulate, and nobody knew.
That's it. Russian. He said Russian will throw him out.
And he said, no. This contract allows me to do it. And the contract was in Russian, so nobody could decipher it.
Exactly.
All right. Yeah. No, but I'm surprised that you got beaten up.
No, because
usually what used to happen is that the wife used to come down to beat the person.
They were on the way. Lift got stuck in the middle. But Kunal was the real reason, because when the fight started, he started screaming, and he first started screaming in Marathi.
And they were all from elsewhere.
UP. Listen. And he started all his anti-North Indian bias and all this Shiv Sainik stuff came out about why you here, Mala City Madi, and all that nonsense.
Maza City Madi.
Then he lost the Marathi, so he switched to Hindi. Then he lost the Hindi, so he switched to English.
They would have understood, no?
Yeah, but not his Hindi. And then when he finished Hindi, he went to English. So while they're hitting me with even more kunnas, because he's talking English, saying, "Go back to UP! You don't belong here!" Of course, he didn't raise a finger, voice.
I think, were you sure that they were from UP or Russian?
It was a mix. They were being directed by the Russians, but they were from UP.
That's what, you know, people don't realize, but you know, since I stayed there for the first 20 odd years of my life, I used to always think that the Russian concept, something was going on, because every time, and I could see the consulate from my residence, you know. So the moment it used to become like 11:30, the lights used to become very dim. And I think the roots of the Russian mafia started there.
Wow.
So that's why I think Shyamnivas has a history of violence.
So in a way, Shyamnivas owns Chelsea Football Club and a few others.
I'm sure.
And we don't know about it.
We don't even know whether Shyamnivas is actually owned by those guys, or it's owned by
Roman, it's a Russian. Shyamnivas. It's a Russian word. People don't know that. All right.
Correct.
Now, coming back to your lovely journey, Manish Jhaveri, tell us from the beginning, how the hell did you land up in this creative field?
Okay, so I actually did architecture. Wow. And I used to always like writing,
what's your dad's background?
Both my parents are doctors.
Okay, so you already failed in their eyes. You went up to architecture.
Yeah, so I said that, all right, what's the closest? I mean, where the failure is not considered too big. Huh. But I didn't want to be a doctor, because I used to see my dad,
Long hours.
Walking like a zombie at like 2 o'clock. Somebody used to call him, dad is really serious.
That's
used to
a tough one, no, when you're a doctor. Take the call or not? Because in one, there's also a social issue and moral issue. On the other end, you also have a life.
But in those days, you didn't have a mobile phone. So when the phone rang,
you knew it was for him.
It had to be for him, because, you know, in every room there was, you know, I don't know, I mean, so, but in those days there used to be an extension thing in rooms.
So if there's a call and the guy says, "Hello, Dr. Jhaveri, I'm dying."
Couldn't hear him, because unless you weren't doing anything and you sort of just said, "All right, sir, mera hernia
so bahut
kharab ho gaya,
aap
aa sakte hain kya?"
Hernia?
What is
hernia specialist?
No,
you chose architecture and erections. He's with hernia. Excellent. Going down generations. So no doctor for you. You decided it was too tough?
Yeah.
Or not, the lifestyle was not
yours? I wasn't into
working these odd hours and all.
Medicine never attracted me. Hmm. Architecture was like, you know, I tried for IIT also, but you know, in those days you were very confused. Yeah.
You did the entrance exam?
I did the entrance exam, but I didn't get in. I just missed. 2002. Only 2000 kids got in. I got 2002.
Oh, balls. How do you know you got 2002?
They told me.
Who told you?
They called me.
They said,
"Make
it up." Boss, that's the same answer to everyone who didn't get in.
Actually,
boss, do aadmi ki baat hai.
Usually I say I got 1998, but I'm saying 2002 to you.
I think that's a tough one. I think that guy was just being nice. We'll never know. Will they give you the score post there?
No, they don't. They don't have the time to do all that.
But did you do all the studying and all that you had to?
Yeah, that's sad part.
Oh, God. Can't bring that back.
Really bad. So it's like, you know, when I see my daughter, and you know, in our
Please don't tell me she became a...
No, she's 16. But she's giving 10th now.
But what will she do? Any idea?
She likes design. She's a very good designer. But the thing is that, you know, she didn't want to do maths.
Right.
But, you know, wives being wives.
Blame it on your wife. Make sure she doesn't hear the podcast.
I must tell you that she's a stand-up comedian, and she's the world's first stand-up comedian who became...
Who's the stand-up comedian? Your wife?
Yeah, my wife.
What are you saying?
She became a stand-up comedian 2 years ago, and the first stand-up comedian who won a title. She's won a pageant, recently. Yeah, recently.
She won a Miss India.
Mrs. Earth India. It's not Miss India.
I've done one of these shows.
So just 2 months ago, she just won that, and she became the first comedian in the world to win a beauty pageant. But anyway, we are talking about my daughter.
Because Donald Trump can't apply now, so I guess it'll stay.
No, that's why.
But that's amazing, huh?
Yeah, yeah. No, so that's why when she entered
actually
party,
blossomed later. Yeah. In a sense.
So what happened is that... No, not because of me.
Arre,
but what
credit, yeah.
Arre, nahi, yeah. Arre, see, what happened is, she was also in advertising. But like so many women we know, she put it all on the back burner.
I don't know any women.
Oh, you don't know.
You'll be very careful.
Come on, man. Anyway, so like so many women we know, she put her career on the back burner. To, you know, become a homemaker
for
full-time.
For the Lord and Master, yeah.
No, not for me. I wanted her to earn more money, but she said, no, I want to make homes. Yeah. So, whatever. So, the thing is, and then suddenly when the daughter has grown up, she says, okay, now I can start reliving my dream. So, just a couple of years ago,
I mean, where did this
come from?
She
was always funny. Not as funny
as me, but
pretty
funny. Early marriage and all.
That's why she married me. No? That's why she has to be funny.
Yeah. She appreciates humor. Yeah. Fair enough. Yeah.
No. So, then, and, you know, a year and a half ago, she started this. And 2 months ago, she took part in this. And I didn't even know.
But may I say something?
Please.
She sounds more interesting than you. Can we replace
That's
you?
That's what
her?
I'm telling you. Yeah. Just call
phone
her.
She
keeps telling me that. Why the hell are you going and not me?
But her story is very...
Deepa, if you're listening to this, even Cyrus wants
actually,
you more
Manish,
than...
Manish, the whole idea of our podcast was to find interesting people. Who have turns and spins in their life and land up. This is the kind of story that
I
really
was a spinner,
huh?
Leg spinner. Tha, but then I broke my arm.
But you've always been in this field, you know. Yeah. Basically, you didn't do IIT, but after that, you've been in this field. But her story is fascinating. You're a mother, and then later on you go... And you win a beauty pageant, plus you're a comedian. Have you heard...
Comedian means 2 years back only, 1.5
Baba,
years back.
Have you heard beauty pageants talk? The girls talk at beauty pageants.
So they were
it's
shocked
very painful
that she could,
normally.
I know. So that's what they were shocked
love,
that she actually
They still
made
love
sense.
Mother Teresa. Of course, now they can't remember her name. Yeah. They say, I love mother. You, that Calcutta mein
mother Teresa. There is.
Something.
There is a hai.
Teresa. That's Bappida. Bappida says mother Teresa. Maybe that's the right pronunciation. I don't know.
Yeah.
Don't
but I think Bappida is actually, we should consider him a national treasure. Like how...
The jokes apart.
But USA, no, I'll tell you, I'm saying, see, USA has Fort Knox, we have Bappida. And I think Bappida has more gold than Fort Knox.
Fair
we
enough,
should just
yeah.
consider him a national treasure, and that's it.
No,
in fact, you know, he was
you
the first Indian musician who featured in the Grammys. He was on the jury of the Grammys. That
by
time
mistake,
they called it Kilo Grammys.
Yeah.
But he was the first Indian musician to feature on the jury of the Grammys.
But for me, I'm saying that if you give India or the world a song like Disco Station, you have to be an icon for life.
I agree.
Disco Station, Disco. Ow! That was very important.
I'm not
participating in this podcast. I'm cancelling it. That, what did, I, my whole life was made because of that one. Ow!
You, even Disco 82 is his.
Disco 82.
And now see, the main thing is anybody can make sense.
Yeah.
But to do things which are so silly and still have people...
And do more of it.
And still have people singing those lines.
Yes.
People who might be ashamed to sing those lines.
You're an IIT grad almost.
Yeah, almost, almost.
And you're doing Disco 82.
The gradation was slightly wrong. They should have had like 5,000 I would have probably gotten. But what the hell.
What a guy. But you know, I want to just say this. I don't want to sound like a nutcase, but honestly, there's something about Bappi I like.
I like
I know we're making fun about the gold and the, you know, he's a large guy and all that. But
No.
His disco music is in our blood, you know, growing up. You know, that's accepted.
So, I went to a Diwali party a few days ago. Most of the people
that
were
wife swapping.
No, not that kind.
Maine suna hai, bhai. Maine suna hai. Shaam Nawaz society mein sab kuch hota
hai. Main Shaam Nawaz mein nahi rehta hu, yaar. Main Shaam Nawaz mein nahi rehta
hu. Weekend pe jaate hai.
Nahi, yaar, nahi. Acha, but you've heard so much more about Shaam Nawaz because you stay closer.
Why do you think the wife wanted to beat me up? Nobody wanted my car key. Sorry, saying.
And you know the playlist, the last I think 1 hour, I don't remember the last 1 hour that I remember.
But what age group?
Our age group.
They'll play 80s, 90s
music. So the last 1 hour was only Bappida songs.
There you go.
Disco 82, Disco Station. Just
I am a disco dancer.
Now see,
you know the moves.
But I'm saying that disco dancer, the original. Okay, everybody knows that all the songs were copied. But what I would like to say in Bappida's favor is that his copies were far better than the originals. Do you remember that video killed the radio star?
Radio star.
And you hear his version in
what
Disco
is his
Dancer. Which is that song, yaar? Or Jimmy.
Jimmy, Julie.
No, Jimmy is his one, yaar.
Jimmy, which was also the original version.
Which was also called Jimmy. He didn't change the words.
He didn't bother. Applause. He didn't bother to change the name.
Yeah. Now,
that is super creative.
And what I liked about Bappi is...
Genius.
What I liked about him
how
is...
How can you copy him the same name?
So he said that, look, I'm not ashamed of copying it because I'm going to make it better.
Of course.
Yeah. And what I liked about him is that, you know, they'd use a snatch of one of his songs in some English song in USA.
Right.
They'd use a snatch of his song.
Yes.
And he sued them.
Yes.
For copying his song.
Yes. That's called having big balls. Wow. But again, I'm saying, we really liked him growing up, and he's part of our DNA.
Yeah, absolutely.
Maybe the next generation won't get it so much and just think of him as a figure of ridicule. Yeah. But for me, along with the madness of all the fun we are making, there's something in that whole disco movement that came with him. Yeah. And the fact he was so bindas.
Yeah.
He was so bindas. And then when you can go on stage, because Bengali doesn't have the male-female gender.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
And say things like, ab mere gaan sunonga and...
violence. Mere gaan mein hamesha violence
hota hai.
So, you know, then sax or violence mein, wo isliye thoda sa jo humko hamesha aishak karta hai. You know, so anyway, I will not get into that.
Tribute.
But I am a fan of Bappi.
I'm also a fan. Yeah. I'm really
happy.
Should we say that pan? I'm a pan.
He was the best.
He was the best.
Best.
Yes.
Ever.
All right, Manish. Before we go into a break or anything else, I want to just set this up. That you finished. You didn't get into IIT. You got into architecture. How did you get into this business?
So I used to do a lot of exhibition design.
You didn't tell the Diwali party story.
Which one? No, I told you, the Bappida. After that,
Bappida.
That, I don't remember the last half an hour or 45 minutes of
because
what
you
happened.
Were taking too
and
many
And it wasn't in Shamnivas. It was here. Very close in car.
I won't give the address.
Are you mad or what?
Party's over. People will still go.
I know. Huh. I can.
So how did you?
I used to do a lot of exhibition designs, and the exhibitions were invariably curated by advertising agencies.
Right.
So one of the agencies was Interpub, and I didn't much care for the
in town.
Yeah, in town.
Run
by Baba.
Yeah.
That's where I met my wife.
Riyadh.
Riyadh's mother.
Riyadh's mom. Right. See, I'm not Alzheimer's setting in, but it's there.
You remember it. I remember
everything.
But this was earlier than Bappi also.
Yeah, true.
She was like the, you know,
one of the iconic
figures. And she sort of gave a lot of people.
Where is in the pub now?
I don't know.
Oh.
I only know the second part. I know a lot of the pubs, but I don't know where that
moment.
Is.
Okay. Anyway, coming back to you. So you Interpub, she asked you to join on what?
No. So what happened is that I was designing one of the exhibitions
your
for
Interpub.
Your
architectural stuff.
Yeah, my architectural stuff. Exhibition design was one of the things we specialized in. And I came across posters that they were doing for one of their clients, which were not very, very interesting. And I told her that, you know, these are really, it's not my job, but they're not
you
very good.
You sort of criticized it.
Yeah, I sort of criticized it. And she was very open. She said, okay, can you write me some better stuff? I said, yeah, fine. And I wrote her some stuff there and then, which she liked a lot.
Hmm.
And she said, why don't you drop in whenever you can and we can, you know,
so
do some sort
Mrs.
of
Wadia,
collab.
Mrs. Wadia created you. She's the catalyst from which you made the move. Well, you wouldn't have moved. You might have been an architect.
I wouldn't have, yeah.
Today, you've been designing a bridge which collapsed somewhere in Central
Mumbai. Which probably collapsed on somebody coming from Hanging Gardens through here.
Correct.
That would have been really sad.
Correct.
<you know? laughs>
That's me.
I didn't say that.
Point your finger. Yeah. You'd be under the bridge writing lyrics. Disco dancer. Rhymes with pisco panzer. I don't speak Bengali. Okay, we'll take a quick break. We'll come back and we'll look at your rise from this meeting with Mrs. Wadia to where you are today, where you write about 10,000 scripts and writing is your thing.
Yeah.
Although now your wife is overtaking you as a comedian.
Yeah.
All this and more when we come back with Manish Jhaveri, also known as MJ.
This is the amazing story of something awesome. Once Chuck decided to start a podcast, and so he did. The end. Okay, that was a crappy story. But I've got some really cool stories over at my new show, The Origin of Things. On this podcast, I look at the stories of how brands came into being and sometimes evolved out of quite unexpected circumstances. And to make it really fun, I reveal the name of the brand and sometimes a category only at the very end. The show is 5 to 7 minutes per episode and perfect for trivia junkies and brand nerds, especially those with short attention spans. New episodes out every Wednesday on IVM Podcasts app or website or any podcast app or site that you happen to prefer. End of story, they lived happily ever after.
Boom. Not true. Sorry, I have to apologize. I called him MJ. He's never been called MJ. There's only one MJ, Michael Jackson, who is there, Bappi Lahiri, in a sense, right?
Yeah.
He was also a little wild and you can't quite explain him. See, these guys, there's some icons you can't explain.
And
right?
Like Bappi, he also used to kid around.
Oh, stop it. Stop
Sorry.
It. That was too much.
Sorry.
Unnecessary. There's no proof in any case with Michael J. That I think he may just be one of those guys who was intellectually a bit of a dwarf. You know,
there's I think no. He actually he was
happier with younger
he was
minds.
Abused. No. He was greatly abused by his
father. Is it
father?
Uncle?
His father chemically castrated him so that he could continue having that
high voice. Yeah.
So I think he was just.
I mean, that's real. That's love for your child. You know, I mean, really. Thinking that, well, otherwise, who would remember Michael Jackson? Just such a common name. I mean, who, any American must be called Michael Jackson. Like, that's it.
But I mean, both of them are so common names.
Yes,
you know?
Thanks to the chemical castration. Bappi does not. Bappi Lahiri is a once in a lifetime name. Yeah. I don't think there's a second Bappi Lahiri.
Lahiri, yeah. Maybe.
He called Bappi his son Bappa Bappa, though.
Yeah, because he thought that Bappi.
Do you have any idea why they use the name twice? It's like, are they hard of hearing or something? You go, Bappa, Bappa.
No, I think normally bongs, you know, usually give a pet name
to... Yeah, Tum Tum, Tum Tum,
correct,
all
correct.
That, yeah.
So here, Bappa was his actual name and it sounded like a pet name. So he said that your pet name is also Bappa. So that nobody can forget your...
This is similar to Jimmy, and I'll use the same name in my copy. Yeah. Your philosophy is now being understood by millions of people listening
millions,
to our podcast.
Millions of people.
Yes, yes. Okay, please don't write letters. Or we again say we really love Bappi. I'm not trying to be funny. We actually, me and Manish, our generation, we love the guy. Whatever fun we make of him.
He was a genius.
He was.
So he didn't know it.
And we're still dancing.
And though many people don't know it.
You went to a Diwali party and you're dancing to his
tracks. And I dance to his songs.
End of the day,
I'm proud of it.
Exactly. I mean, honestly, with due respect, I didn't like Gully Boy. I'm a few of those people who didn't. I won't be able to dance to those songs. Up that time,
nobody
I
can dance to those songs.
Is it our age thing?
No.
I think it's an age thing.
Maybe, but people, no, I don't think it's a dance.
You don't like Gully Boy.
Huh.
They look at me like I did something wrong. Okay, but I don't like it.
No, I can't dance to it. It's a good movie and all, but it's not as good a movie as they make it out to be. I've seen far better movies.
Yeah. It's just a Slumdog Millionaire. You know, it's a little patronizing after some time. Mere liye kuch nahi, yaar. I want Bond. Bond. James Bond.
I thought that you were talking about chess.
This is your this is your story. Tell me what happened, Mrs. Wadia. Put a hand on your shoulder.
So I was in Interpub for a very brief period of time.
You were still going to be an architect.
Yeah, I mean, I was doing a lot of exhibition design at that time. But I used to go to Interpub too. But then what happened is I started getting work from around, from close by.
Uh-huh.
And I
word
bumped
got
into...
Around. Word
yeah,
got around.
Word got around, yeah, okay. So, you know, and, you know, what happened is when people leave one agency and go to another one, if they've got a rapport with the writer, they invariably ask him to do some freelance work.
Right.
And I started getting a lot of freelance work. And I joined Avenues for a bit.
Avenues.
Yeah.
Let me ask people from the millennial generation. Anyone? Avenue? No, nobody. Okay, go on.
Okay, so that was at Worli. So my aim at that time was not to travel too much.
Stay in the area.
Yeah. Not to travel too much.
So Worli is okay, Colaba is okay.
Fine,
nothing more.
Yeah, so this and Interpub was apna near Grand Hotel.
Huh.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
So,
I remember
somebody there.
No, we used to pack food from there
in the
old days. Now I've not gone
now
for
Now
years.
I don't know whether it's there also or not.
No, it's there. It's there.
Okay.
Why? Where will it go? It's such a big hotel.
No, they must have sold it, or they must have, you know, who knows?
Yeah. Outside there's a poster of Bappi. No.
It's not that
story.
Grand.
Story. So, people
so
said.
Then, anyway, I went to
your
Avenue.
Started doing
I went to, and Avenue said that no, now we need you to join us full time. So I was like.
So they offer a proper salary and all.
Not much, but I said that, all right, I will join them. I will join them, but I'll see whether I can still do my work.
Oh, God. Pick moment with the sneeze. See what you did, Manish. One nipple,
cold comfort.
One nipple has come out. Okay, I'll put it back slowly. Please, don't let me stop your flow.
No. So
you took the job.
I took the job. And after a while...
What happens to architecture and all?
So I had a partner. And he used to do more of the work. Yeah. So he used to do more of the work, and he used to stay in Worli just next to Avenues. So it used to be really convenient.
You had two offices.
No. So he used to stay there. Huh. So I used to, like, so whenever we used to get, and I was specializing in exhibition design. So whenever we used to get the work, his name was Sanjeev. I used to tell him that, okay, boss, this is the thing, this is the thing. I used to do a little bit of conceptualization. And since I was in advertising, I used to get a lot of clients from there.
Hmm.
So we did one exhibition for Avenues itself, for Onida.
Hmm.
When Avenues used to handle the Onida exhibition.
The one with the devil.
The one with the devil. So we had these cutouts made out of tin and in Pragati Maidan, Delhi, which won a gold.
I got lost there.
Yeah, it's massive.
Somebody told me, just wave your white handkerchief. Boss, there were 10,000 people. It was like a whole city. Anyway.
It's massive.
I still haven't found him. Stick on.
So anyway, I was there for a bit. And then I sort of met Kunal. I don't remember where exactly.
Kunal?
Vijaykar.
Oh, then you moved to Dacunia's.
So, and see, you know, the thing is, let me tell you a little bit about Dacunia's.
Huh.
When I was in college, when I was in Jahin, this is even before I was in architecture.
Mm-hmm.
So when I was in Jahin in the 12th standard, I, you know, used to love the Amul hoardings like many kids of our age.
Kids of our age,
maybe a little older than you.
Your wife is a comedian, but the people listening aren't.
Yeah. So I, you know, thought that anybody could do these hoardings. So I just sort of sauntered into, I found out who does the hoardings, and I just sauntered into the Dakuna's office.
You found
office.
The guy who sells fruit at the Nariman Point.
I asked him. So I went to Dakuna's, I found out, and I just sort of sauntered in, and I spoke to the creative people there. I said, you know, at that time, we were in New Zealand. India was in New Zealand getting hammered. John Wright, who then coached India.
Right. I'm saying right as in R-I-G-H-T.
I'm saying W.
I
okay.
Know. Just
for
to clarify,
one of the brothers.
Audio things people won't understand. Right. They can't read it. Right. You're right.
All right. My right.
Yeah,
okay, great.
Yeah.
So, fundamental right is to
talk. India was getting hammered?
India was getting hammered. And they'd come up with a hoarding. And I thought that I wrote a better hoarding and I went to them.
Do you remember both?
My thing was right on top. It was a baseline.
And this?
And, I don't know. But it wasn't as good.
There's no India lost.
It couldn't be that bad.
India lost. It's like kuch nahi hai. Let's move on.
So I went there and I told him that, you know, you got a decent line, but I think this line is better. So why didn't you use this? Because I had no clue as to how advertising worked. So, you know, those people looked at me and said, thank you very much. Aapka matlab, thank you very much for your help. The moment we need it, we will use it. Let him score another double century. Next double century, mein wo karega na, we will use it. And that was my experience with Dakuna. So then when I went back after so many years and I told Kunal this, you know, when I was working with
Avenues. Kunal, who knows nothing about cricket.
Vijaykar.
Yeah, who knows nothing about cricket.
He knew a little bit about cricket because he got the name right. He got the first letter right. He said, Jack Wright. I said, no, John Wright.
Okay. He might be called Jack also. It's a pet name.
So, you know, it was a full circle. And then when I sort of joined, I was full time with Dakuna's for a few years only. And I told Rahul that, see, though I'm not doing exhibition design anymore because now writing was like
the main thing,
really time consuming. But I was doing work for a lot of agencies, so I told him that I can't continue coming here, and he was big enough to let me continue doing the Amul hoardings, and I became a full time part timer.
Right now you're an Amul butter specialist, Amul hoarding specialist, and you're also writing for
whoever
you want.
I work for IBD, which is another agency in Lower Parel, and I work for a lot of other clients also directly.
Do you work for the BJP or the Congress?
No.
Have you worked for any political party?
No.
Are you a communist?
No.
Do you have deviant sex which nobody knows about?
Yes.
Okay, fair enough. Then you're on the right show. See, we need something you can sell to sponsors.
Yeah, correct.
Okay, let's fast forward a little bit. So then you started getting fame as a writer.
Yeah.
And then you started getting to this other, people don't know about this other side, which is events, which is huge. Yeah. And you started writing events as well.
Yeah, so what happened is that, you know, as, again, I don't remember the exact time, but I met Javed Jafri. Around 18 years ago, 18 to 20 years ago. And, you know, somebody introduced me as a guy who writes the Amul hoardings. He said, oh, you must come and do this show with me. I said, I haven't
Which
written.
Show?
An event. See, I'm doing an event. So I want some funny
Writers.
Guys to help write the event with me. I said, look, but I haven't ever written an event before. He said, no, I mean, just keep the Amul idiom in mind. And I'm also a great punner and whatever else. Come, let's try to write this show. So I started with him around 18, 20 years ago. And then after that, I, you know, he sort of told but his friends about
me. You know something
me.
About Javed? He recognizes anybody anywhere. If you work with him once, he has that talent like Napoleon apparently had. Napoleon could look at anyone in the army and say, Andre, you know, Pierre. The French have only four names. Andre, Pierre, Jacques, and Gaston. And, you know,
Henri.
There's more?
Henri,
okay,
Henri.
Five, Henri, Henri. And you like your football. Nah. And so apparently Javed has got that ability. So he can, Baman Irani, somewhere has that ability. Sajid Khan as well. They can sort of tell the person immediately. But with just one meeting, a painter who would come to the house in 1992 and painted one wall. Pandurang. Yes, sir.
A painter should have a name like that. Pandurang.
Yeah. Matlab,
in your name only.
See, like the Parsi. I'm also copywriter, na? Jimmy. Yeah.
Like Parsis. No, that's why I think that Parsi is bandukwala. Means you know that he's the guy you go to when you want to shoot yourself.
Parsi is like clarity.
Yeah. Very clear.
When you soda, bottle, water, opener wala and all, it's very clear. The job is very complex. Yeah. Pehla opener, second bottle.
Or still soda.
Only soda.
Daru ke liye kisi koi aur hai hamare paas.
Opener wala means open it also, na? Who don't open it? Your pop? No. Sorry.
No, I like that. I mean, that's why I like Parsis. Unfortunately, they're a dwindling community. And that's really
historical
sad.
Respect. So you've got into this thing where you're now writing for a lot of different people, and you get into events with Javed.
Yeah.
And Javed was doing a lot of events for some time. Javed and his brother Naved and his best friend Ravi Bell.
Correct.
So they had a lot of.
I did a lot of events. See, the thing is, I think that over the last 5-6 years, the event industry basically, if the event industry runs on cash, Right. Or used to run on cash.
Yeah.
So when Demon happened...
You're blaming Namo now.
No, so when
Demon
happened...
You're pointing fingers at the BJP. No. Manish Jhaveri with a name like that, you're turning your back on your brothers.
I think demonetization. I think demonetization.
Screwed it up for a year at least.
I think.
And right into the wedding season, man.
Wedding season. So I think now people are just running away. That you know they are being encouraged that please elope because we do not have the cash.
Correct.
To fund a wedding. Just elope.
Just cross the border, Bangladesh. All good.
No, right. I think that I think historically, maybe after 5 years, they look upon demonetization as the biggest mistake ever done.
Yeah.
If they aren't already looking.
But anyway, cash is back now. People are still using cash.
That's why they will look upon demonetization is the biggest mistake done because it slowed down the economy tremendously.
And I feel it hurt all the wrong people.
Middle
class people, like my poor old mother was standing in line. You know, I was out of town, I remember. And
she was standing in line for you or for herself?
For everyone. We're there to take out money from banks, boss.
Very, very sad.
Manish, we didn't have money under the bed. We're Parsis. It's very difficult.
What about that?
Yeah, so there's a lot of... So all the normal senior citizens and you know middle class people just suffering. It was just unnecessary.
It was unnecessary.
You're not catching that, you know, that rokra businessman who's getting away with murder and also.
So my thing was always that. That, you know, if you wanted to erase black money, then you know that the money that was in Swiss accounts is 100% black money.
Correct.
You knock that off first.
There was a promise to do that. That didn't happen.
And you knock that off first na, because that you know is illegal black money.
Correct.
Here what happens is it's money that people who don't trust banks. And now today if somebody says there's a bank robbery, you don't know whether the bank is robbing you or you are robbing a bank.
Also a lot of people were scared, intimidated. You look at the lower working class force of India.
They can't get into an HDFC. I'm saying even a businessman who's earning a lot of money, he's a little intimidated by HDFC. Those guys come in suits.
I don't
and
have a bank account till today. I give my money to Abbas and he gives me a washing machine every month. He come and see my
that's
house.
That's why your clothes are so clean.
No.
One cloth per washing machine.
We sit on the washing machine. They're furniture for us. Right. Remember, you keep digressing.
No, but a washing machine is a good way of laundering your money.
I was thinking, what else to do? There you go. Award-winning ad man once again. Okay, we are running out of time. Quickly, I want to get into IFA also. Give me a couple of big events. So you've done IFA, which
has... So I did a couple of IFA awards. There was one in Singapore.
Now they're back in Bombay. I don't know. Paisa gaya.
So I'll tell you, it was a very good script, but I worked harder to get my money from them than to actually do the bloody script.
Sabas.
It was really bad.
Sabas.
It was very bad. So after that,
Singapore.
Singapore. So, you know, it was the one where Farhan Akhtar and where they took off on...
Who's the second host? Saif.
No, not Saif.
Farhan and Karan.
Pankaj Kapoor's son. Shahid Kapoor.
Shahid Kapoor. Yeah. You're like me, na? Pankaj Kapoor son. Good. 80s generation. Bappi da. Pankaj Kapoor ka beta naam kya hai?
So Farhan and Shahid were the hosts. And it was quite a... It was a blast. It was very funny. And good times.
So did you have to sit and correct them all the time? Give the script and they do their own thing?
They did their own thing. They used to make sure that they would never be there together so that the writer had to run a little bit more. So one guy would give time. I mean, of course, one was in Santa Cruz, one was in Drew. I don't know. They might have gotten along. But one was in his office in Santa Cruz. The other guy lived in Juhu. So they used to never sort of meet.
Which
so
is
the
not
writer
that
had to
far.
Go.
They could meet.
Which is not that far. Yeah. Except if you're having to go from Santa Cruz to Juhu.
Correct.
So after that, I realized that it's not really something a sane person does.
Okay. So where are you right now? What all is on the plate?
So right now I do work for a lot of social media. I do plenty of social media work. I consider myself a little lucky that I got the hang of social media before it sort of...
took off.
Yeah, before it took off and before it became like... Even now, for example, Instagram, though I do a lot of work on Insta, they keep coming up with new stuff.
I couldn't put it on yesterday.
So I can't keep track of so much new stuff. You know, and I think Insta though has a special team to keep on... coming up
just
with some new innovations.
I think it's just to screw the older people.
No, they're scared actually because Facebook is now an old man's domain. So Instagram wants to, and Instagram is also afraid of the invasion of the oldies.
My 12-year-old daughter uses these filters and shows me pictures and she's laughing and her friends are laughing and all that. When I use the filter, she's appalled. She looks at me like I'm mental, like I'm absolutely mad. She's like, Dad, we can't even see you. What are you trying to do? And now I've lost confidence with the medium. I'm like, can I just go on stage and talk
idea.
To an audience?
So
I don't think I can do anything else.
No, I'm saying that's the whole idea of all these new media. The moment they feel that people above 40 are getting to understand them, they say,
this
course. What the hell do we do?
You're right.
Let's just bloody make it so difficult. Let's make it like, you know, thumbs so, which weigh less than 10 grams cannot press the button. Something like that.
So our thumbs are fat? Old man? Is that what you're saying?
I think your thumb is even my better thumb, than mine.
I've got knobbly fingers. I'm not, okay, you know, I can't press anything, man. You can ask all the people I've dated. And I say people, not just, you know.
So you're a press agent.
After some time, yeah. Free press? Want to keep going? No? Yeah. Stop. Okay, well, we've got to end it here, but very quickly, let's get back to the wife. So is there any competition? Because generally, you have one funny person in the family or one creative person. Now you have two.
Yeah.
And it looks like she's taking it very seriously as well. So how does
so
that
she's,
work?
You know, so I think that it's, you know, I wanted to retire after 2 years. So I'm thinking that I'll retire very soon. And Deepa Jhaveri, that's my wife's name,
will start
can, yeah,
on
can,
the
can
journey.
Do all the hard yards.
So you'll be the carrier. You'll be the Uber guy.
Yeah,
no?
I'll
pick,
be the
drop,
yeah,
carry,
ha,
pick.
Correct.
Man,
I don't mind
script,
doing that.
Script bhul gaya.
I'll be, let her be number one. I'll be the coolie. Coolie number one.
I have
one.
No problem with all this.
Yeah, absolutely not.
What is your daughter's name?
Anushka.
What does Anushka feel about the two parents? Do you have any idea? Does she think you're the crazy one? Or
I don't know, but I think she has more fights with Deepa because she's the one who monitors her studies. And, you know, that's always a hate point with kids.
Are you a good father? Tough question.
I hope so.
Huh?
I hope so. I think I am.
People ask me this all the time. Are you a good father? I don't know what to say.
I don't go to church. You should just
say
that.
I don't know. But what exactly? What is a good father?
I know. What is a good? You should.
Ridiculous.
How can you ask somebody and say, "Are you a good father?"
I say
it's not like you're a batsman and you have an average to say, "Yeah."
I said it's science. Mushkil se main father ban gaya. Let's not push it into good father and fat father and thin father. All right, Manish. Thank you so much for being on the show. Is there anything that's coming out now that you want to talk about?
So I just did a hoarding recently. I mean, since
I just saw hoarding.
No, there's one hoarding which I sent yesterday, which I think will come out very, very soon. Let me see if I've got it here. So I think this is a very special hoarding because I've been a great fan of Asterix for many, many years. And they have their first female superhero called Adrenaline.
Huh.
And this is the Amul hoarding that we did on that. So it's a very special one for me.
I lost it now and
sorry,
I can't
sorry,
figure
okay.
out how to go back.
Fat fingers, I know.
Yeah.
Hold on. There it is.
So Asterix actually is right up your alley, no?
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
funny. It's the pictographically funny.
Yeah, yeah. In fact, you know, Asterix wanted to come to India with a Hinglish version. Chavi. I shall show it to you from far.
Okay, what's
you
happening why we're laughing is every time he passes me the phone, I press something on the phone and Asterix disappears.
Yeah, can you see this?
Yes. Now he won't let me touch the phone. Hence, we're all laughing. Yeah. Okay, I'm looking. It's like a television set. I've seen it from far now. Yeah. Yeah. So, Amul, can we see the line? It's
yeah, of course.
Amul, increase your adrenaline.
That's the baseline. The headline is Asterix, try some Amulix.
Yeah.
And below you have Amul, increase your adrenaline.
Yeah.
That's the character's name.
Yeah.
And it's special because I've been a fan of Asterix for the longest time.
I don't even speak French. And I absolutely loved it.
But maybe you were good at other French stuff.
Ooh, erotic Jhaveri.
French fries, Baba.
Now you're making fun of my pee-pee. Okay, Manish, thank you so much for being on the show. But we're going to the EMAs. Are you there? Is he there? He is there. He'll stay with us for 2 minutes.
Hey, everybody, welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you aren't following us on social media, please make sure you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Also, quick reminder, please do fill out our survey. It's at ivmpodcast.com/survey. It's a listener survey. We're trying to understand more about who's listening to our stuff, what kind of things you would like to see from us in the future, what you have been seeing so far, what you think of it. What shows you like, all kinds of different stuff. Also who you are, right? So I mean like all kinds of different stuff. Just please do come in and fill it out. It'll be really helpful. That's ivmpodcast.com/survey. Want to thank our sponsors this week, Cambly, Intel, and Storytel. Remember, sponsors are what make this stuff possible. So if you enjoy the content, please do thank our sponsors. We have two new shows releasing this week. Lakshmi Krishnan, better known as Literary Chills on Twitter, talks to agents of literary culture on her show Litnama. She plunges deep into new genres of literature born in the digital era as she talks to the performers, storytellers, bloggers, poets, and writers. New episodes are out every Tuesday from 10th December. The Traveling Professor's Diary is hosted by Siddharth Deshmukh. It's a show about a curious human being with an eagerness for travel and observation. He visits colleges such as MICA, SP Jain, Symbiosis, Flame, Upgrad, Talent Age, and spreads the digital gospel of design, marketing, and business transformation. Episodes are out every Tuesday and Thursday starting 10th of December. This week, The Seen and the Unseen celebrates its 150th episode. Amit is joined by publisher and editor V.K. Karthika. She talks about her journey of publishing and highlights the need of diversity in a publishing house. This week on IVM Likes, Abbas and Alakar are joined by me, Amit Doshi, along with Pawan Srinath, who hosts our Pragati podcast and Thala Arate. We discuss our favorite fantasy fiction movies, books, and everything else. Do tune in. It's quite a fun conversation. And we talk about all kinds of weird stuff. On Storytellers and Storysellers, Vineet is joined by storyteller Anisha Dixit, better known as Rikshawali, and storyteller Tracy D'Souza, former channel head at TVF's Garliapa. They talk about the future of women creators in India, how they work with brands, and how their teams perceive them as leaders. On Ganatantra, Saryu and Alok unpack what happened in Maharashtra after the assembly polls, and how the office of the governor has been misused to meddle in state politics. On Edges and Sledges, Ashwin Varun and DJ focus on the India vs. West Indies T20 series. On GABCD, Sunetra and Farhad talk about relationships and breakups as they share their experiences of navigating through the same and learn to acknowledge their feelings. It's a crossover on the Empowering series as Zarina is in conversation with Chetna, host of Positivity Unlimited. They talk about her shift from the corporate world to life coaching, about positivity and self-belief. On 9XM Soundcast, Eva is joined by Bollywood singer Benny Dayal. They talk about his experience of working with A.R. Rahman and some of his favorite composers in Bollywood. And with that, let's get on with your show.
If you have any questions for Cyrus, write to us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Or you can send an email to whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Okay, we're back here on the AMAs. Abbas has joined us as captain of the ship.
Hi.
Manish Jhaveri is very much here, writing copy for some 17 different people.
For another Amul hoarding that is to go in the next 10 minutes.
Side of him. There you go. See, already working on the sly. Immediately. Just to make some money while doing a silly interview. But this is the AMAs, Manish. Here's hard-hitting questions.
Okay.
I don't know if you can handle them. It's like a Perth wicket. The ball bounces right up to your chin. And there's a short leg. There's a backward short
and
leg.
You look like a bouncer, so it's going to be really dangerous.
Yeah, I've been called worse. Yes.
Okay, this one. First one comes from Chirul Mistry. Hey, Cyrus, have you ever been approached to be on KBC? It's one of the few quiz shows which is popular on TV still. What is your take on quizzing in general?
Just once I was approached, but it's they do this thing where they earn money for some charity. You come and you do part of the thing.
Yeah.
But I don't know why. I can't remember why we didn't go. I was happy to go, actually, but it didn't happen in the end. But they were only going to pay for conveyance.
Okay.
Which at that time was 250 rupees. And which was not fair because I come from Malabar Hill to Film City, which is actually 350 rupees. But they said, sir, hum toh standard hai conveyance, 250. So I said, no, mera 350 hoga. I said, wo toh mera problem nahi hai because we have a standard thing in place. So on 200 rupees, because going and coming both ways, I called up Amitabh Bachchan. He didn't take the phone.
No, but I think that you should have just told him that I don't mind doing it for charity, but just remember that charity begins at home.
Yeah, but his answer would have been, you have four options. Then what am I going to do?
He's like, I have four homes.
Taxi. You should have said, Uber. Chalke.
You should have said, I have four homes. Malabar Hill.
I am going to show off with my wealth to Amitabh Bachchan.
He's got 10 homes.
He's got four homes in Film City. What will I tell you, sir?
Hypothetically.
You live with your parents.
Hypothetically, how much do you think you would have won?
I think they sort of fix it for the so-called celeb or mini celeb or whatever, so that you at least you look really bad. Yeah. You can't have like an Amir Khan coming there and then struggling the first the first one. So I think all of them do at least respectably. But also Amitabh is very encouraging. If you, I don't watch it anymore, but I used to watch it in the beginning a lot. And he's actually trying to help. He hints.
Yeah.
He shoulders. He puts his finger. He repeats the word.
He does this. He does second.
I mean, if you don't get it after that, what are you, nuts? Really? So yeah, but I'm not bad at quizzing. Manish,
he's good.
How are you?
I'm very good.
Yeah. So
I was
we're advertising boys. We know little about everything, right?
I used to do Bonvita, na.
There you go.
Yeah. 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 Pretty good.
Yeah.
Okay, the next one comes from Bhargman Kodi. Hi, Cyrus, are you on LinkedIn? What do you think about it? I find it to be a nightmarish hellscape of corporate jargon and self-congratulatory managers.
See, I don't know how you, if you're actually judging people on these kind of sites, I mean, how do you take it all seriously? Also, if I'm looking for a guy, you know, in sales or marketing, or I'm, you know, trying to push my thing out there, my portfolio. Manish, you're both. You see, you're a corporate guy and a creative guy. You tell me, in a sense.
So I'm on LinkedIn, but I don't. I don't check it. I check it just once a month, and then you know, I just realize that there are so many notifications. And I think I'm on LinkedIn by habit rather than anything else. I've never got a job through LinkedIn.
But you must have put it in the beginning with the big wave.
Correct. And I don't. You know, they keep on saying that. Please, they don't even have my mobile number. You know, they keep saying that your mobile number helps you. Doesn't matter.
So basically, we've lost faith in Lincoln. Yeah. You can see. Not Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah.
He's still the grand preserver.
Of course.
Yeah. Gettysburg address is still the same if you're sending anything. Please carry on.
Okay, this one comes from someone who wants to be anonymous. The question is, hi Cyrus.
This is Kunal Vijaykar. Because he knows both of us, yeah, all three of us actually. It has to be him. And the only other person I know who has no work. Go on.
Hi Cyrus, once again the voter turnout for the Maharashtra elections in South Bombay was less than 40%.
I'm not South Bombay.
No.
His next line is, as the South Bombay spokesperson, it's time for you to justify this again.
No, I will justify it, but I want you to also, because you're a brother of South Bombay. No, you can't say that.
Okay.
You born and bred in bloody South Bombay. You are exactly like all
born
of us from there.
Born, bred, and butter in South Bombay.
So let's accept the slap on the face that we have very low civil and political consciousness. Don't look at yourself personally. I'm saying just generally speaking.
No, I was looking at you actually.
Yeah, me. As a symbol of South Bombay. So that's a fact. We just don't seem to care. It's like we live in our own bubble. This part of Mumbai just lives in its own bubble. It doesn't matter whether people are dying or there are riots or there's this problem or that problem or inflation is all-time high or Sensex is down. No, Sensex is down or upsets us. But, you know, we live in our bubble. That's what I feel. Nobody cares. Why didn't they come out?
I think people who don't vote should not have the right to criticize bad roads. You had the chance to do something about it. You didn't vote. So don't criticize it. Break your back. Go through the potholes because you did not do anything about it. We should actually find out who didn't vote. And if one of those guys, you know, I'm sure it's easy to find out.
It was a full holiday. Everybody was at home. Yeah. There's no reason not to. But they just didn't come. They went to their clubs. They went to their parlours. They went for a holiday because it's a Monday. But nobody came to vote. It's just, I went at 8:45 in the morning. Manish, not a person. I hit the guy, the one policeman sleeping. I slapped him on the chin. And I said, bro, wake up. In English, of course, because now they all speak English. And he said, bro, what's up? Yo. And I said, yo. And then he said, go vote.
I'm sure you're voting for the Maharashtra elections.
I was almost embarrassed that it's going to be so fast. Because that was something to do. I'm going to vote. You can't come back in 10 minutes. Mom is like, what happened?
Done already.
Like, really? So it's an embarrassment, but it's true. And we just got to take it on the chin, man. That we're disgusting. You're right. We don't have any right to crib or criticize if we don't vote. It's a simple process. This is the only time we have a real say in anything. Then for the next 5 years or 4 years,
and
you
done, it's done now.
Yeah. Wow. Anyway, so you vote in Bandra now because you've changed residence. Yeah. And was it a little better there, the turnout?
Yeah, it was a pretty decent.
Who did you vote for? What time?
I will not tell you that.
Show me your finger.
I will not tell you that, but the guy who I voted for didn't win.
He didn't win. Why do you waste your vote? I should have won.
I know. That's what I told myself when I reached home.
Doesn't matter. Building elections, that's where it counts. Do your little bit for the locality. All right, that's all we have time for. Again, for the 15th time, saying the same line. Thank you, Manish, for being here.
We want Deepa on the show
the next time. I will make sure
that she comes here, yeah.
The better Jhaveri. And then one day, ultimately, your daughter, Apeeksha, right?
Anushka.
There goes Alzheimer's. Do you have a daughter called Apeeksha?
Anushka.
It sounds like you could.
I don't know, but I know that I've got a daughter called Anushka.
Are bhai, too much freelancing, huh? Be careful. Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
And that's what Cyrus says.
Janice, what do you think couples did before TV was invented?
I don't know, go for walks on the beach, long drives, fancy dinners, have more sex maybe?
But what did we do when we decided to move in together? We debated between the Chromecast and the Fire Stick.
We gave up on sleeping early so we could stay up watching true crime shows.
We got ourselves 3 cat babies.
And basically became the cutest couch potatoes around.
Okay then.
In case you guys still haven't got it, we are a TV crazy, Netflix loving, binge watching Mr. and Mrs.
I'm Anirudh Guha.
I'm Janice Iquera.
And if like us, you snort TV for breakfast, lunch and dinner, this is the podcast for you.
Tune in every Thursday on the IVM podcast app or wherever it is that you get your podcast from. This is
Mr.
and Mrs.
Binge Watch.
Look, up in the internet. It's a meme. No, it's a cat video. No, it's the Geek Fruit Podcast.
That's right. We interrupt this riveting broadcast to tell you about our show, The Geek Fruit Podcast, where Tejas, Dinkar and I, Jishnu, talk about everything in pop culture, including DC, Marvel, Star Wars, Netflix and everything in between.
You know how your friends hate it when you ramble about some nerdy crap and you just want somebody to listen to you? Well, sorry, there's nothing we can do about that, but come listen to us ramble and it'll almost be like the real thing. Kind of.
Listen to new episodes of the Geek Fruit Podcast every Monday and the Geek Fruit Bulletin every Thursday on iTunes, Google Podcasts, the IVM app, or wherever you listen to podcasts. Happy listening, you nerds.